Welcome to My Awesome Empire. This week, we meet two great people who have helped Inland Empire kids become great, and the youngest kid hero we've ever welcomed. Bobby Avila had a tough time growing up in San Bernardino, but he loved making music. By the time he was an adult, he shared his love for music with his own sons and made history. Bobby Avila was born in San Bernardino in the 1950s. After his dad died suddenly, he struggled with everything except his love for music. When he began his own family, he shared that love with his children, Bobby Ross and Iz, who became increasingly involved in their father's recording and performances until they were making their own music. Today, the Avila brothers are the only Latinos to ever have won a Grammy in the urban category. They produce world-famous acts like Janet Jackson, Usher, and Gwen Stefani. And their father is the subject of an upcoming major motion picture based on his own biography, Fathers, The Journey. Earlier this week, Cal State San Bernardino communication major Arnold Robles sat down with the Fontana dad and asked him what sparked his love for music as a boy.
My father, you know, I remember being 9 years old and seeing that piano come into our living room. My dad was so excited. Our next door neighbor introduced Fats Domino and Little Richard and that to my dad, and my dad loved the music, and that's where it started from, on that piano and just watching my dad teach himself, and I was inspired by music through him.
What was your early career like?
Well, actually, I had some bad experiences. You know, that's the Father's the Journey to the Grammys. The book that I wrote is that's what it's all about. Is that my early career and how I got started in music? I ended up in East Los Angeles on a park bench. You know, I had ran away from home, and I had lost my father at the age of nine. Six months after that piano rolled in, and he was killed in a car accident, and I ended up in East Los Angeles, where my music career started from. When a young man who became a longtime friend, Adrian, saw me on a park bench, took me home, and he just so happened to play in a band. And I played a little guitar, and he taught me how to play bass, and they had a bass player that wasn't on time. And so, you know, the timing, you know, yeah. I was there at the perfect time. And, you know, his dad took me in and kind of raised me for a short period, and I went to Garfield High School, and that's where my music career started from.
When did your boys first become involved in the music?
Well, I would say when the day they were born, I had a plan, you know, if I ever had any sons that I would nurture their careers in that. And I got them into theatrical, doing commercials and movies, and their music became part of their curriculum. And from there, you know, I started nurturing, teaching them. And when I couldn't teach them anymore, I got the best of the best, you know, to come in and teach them as well. And one day I came back from a gig that at the time I was, I had my own groups doing major hotels in Vegas. And one day my oldest son, Bobby Ross, asked me, "Hey, Dad, when am I going to go into the studio?" And I told him, "Well, when I think you're ready." And anyway, I came back from Sacramento, you know, I had got him some drum machines and some keyboards and stuff, and he had three songs prepared. And when I heard them, I go, okay, you know, we got something to work with, you know, so let's give it a go. We'll see what becomes of it. And anyway, we worked on the songs for about a month and a half, and you know, we came up with some good material, and I decided to give my band a notice, a 2-week notice, and that's where we all started from. they worked hard. They worked hard from the ages of four to where they are now. Iz became the drummer for Macy Gray for a couple years. And Bobby, you know, he's been independent, you know, and they became the Avila Brothers. And they formed, and they've been producing great acts like Usher, you know, Mary J. Blige, Chaka Khan, Earth, Wind & Fire, the TLC. I mean, the list goes on and on. They are great musicians. I wish that I was so fortunate, you know, to be as great as they were.
If you just joined us, you're listening to My Awesome Empire. I'm Arnold Robles, and we're speaking with Bobby Avila Sr. of the Inland Empire, father to music producers Bobby and Iz Avila. The two brothers are known for their Grammy Award-winning production of music and currently hold two Grammys in the urban category. They've produced music from artists that include Usher, Janet Jackson, and Mary J. Blige. So how long was it before the Avila brothers began to produce other people's music?
They came to a point in their life where now they were ready to go on their own. When they formed, it was actually after the Macy Gray, and Bobby was signed to Warner Brothers, and when they became the Avila Brothers. And back when we were signed with RCA, things didn't work out so well there, so we moved on to Perspective. When we left RCA, I was going to go independent. Certain things took place, and so I was going to put the album out on my own. And I just happened to be at the mastering lab, and a call came in right in the middle of our mastering, and it was Terry Lewis. And I heard Brian Gardner, he was the engineer, and talking about, well, the young kid and his dad are going independent. And so I looked over at him, and he looked at me, and he said, hey, Senior, Terry Lewis wanted to know if you could send him a copy, a dat, of the music. And I go, Terry Lewis, Jimmy Jam? And he goes, yeah. So, man, I looked all over. I said, where did I leave my briefcase? You know, so, and because I had all my videos and all the rest of the stuff that Bobby's done all throughout the years. And anyway, he just happened to call for Karen White stuff. And, you know, Brian sent it. 2 weeks later, I'm signing a deal with Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis. And that's where it all began. They started producing Macy Gray. And then it led to Chaka Khan and Mary J. Blige and Gwen Stefani and on and on. And so that's what led them to making history, you know, getting their Grammys with Usher. Actually, their first nominee was in 2004 for the Confessions album. They got 9 nominees and sold 15 million global. That's where it pretty much all began for them.
Who would you say gave your boys their biggest break?
Well, of course, Pops did. You know, I'm the root. You know, but the ones that actually opened the door to bigger things was Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis. You know, Bobby was already known nationwide. You know, because of the New Kids on the Block tour, CC Music Factory, and Tony Tone, and all the tours that we did. You know, he developed a fan base over 5 million. But I have to honestly say that Terry and Jimmy had played a big part in their careers today, and they still work together. They're working on Anthony Hamilton today.
They've actually met President Obama too, haven't they? Tell us about that.
Well, they both have. They had at two different times, as Iz was on the OMG tour with the Usher, and he's his main DJ. He's been with him for about 8 years now, and they also produced 6 songs off the Confessions album and 4 songs off Raymond versus Raymond, and that's what they got the other Grammy for. But Bobby went, I guess it was called the Red, White, and Blues, and with Booker T, Mick Jagger, Jeff Beck, all legends. And it's ironic because we go back to your question about their musicianship. Jeff Beck, Bobby didn't show up because he was so fascinated at the White House, just, you know, looking at, you know, walking the grounds, and he didn't show up for the rehearsal. Well, Jeff Beck said, hey, you didn't show up for rehearsals. He goes, my dad played all them songs. I know them all. And he goes, yeah, okay, we'll see. And anyway, you know, he at the end of their week and their shows, Jeff Beck came with his man, and Mick Jagger says, you're the greatest musician we've ever played with. And that was a real honor for Bobby, you know. And meeting Obama was an experience for them. And is happened to go, I guess, 6 months later with Usher at the, I guess, inauguration, I believe. And they had the ballroom dance in that, and Usher performed in that. So, yeah, it was an experience for them to go to the White House. I mean, you know, it was a proud thing for me, too.
So, speaking of proud moments, what has been your proudest moment as a dad?
Well, I, outside of music, I have to say them being born. They became my buddies, you know. I taught them how to fish and hunt and stuff, and, you know, we're pretty much an outdoor family, and that was a proud moment to have some sons and then develop, you know, their careers and put them on a pathway that they made my dreams come true. I mean, you know, they chose music and they made a proud dad out of me, you know. And I think the proudest moment, I have to say, is that when they received their Grammys, that was an emotional part for me, because to be acknowledged and recognized, you know, as the only Latinos to ever receive Grammys in the urban category, man, that's a big plus, you know, and I'm so proud of them.
We heard you're pretty excited about a particular movie that's about to come out. Tell us about that.
Well, you know, after writing and finishing my book in 2004, I was encouraged by friends and a partner that became my partner, Duke Pernet. He's in Thailand now. Introduced me to a scriptwriter, Paula, who wrote the script for Moonlighting, Bruce Willis. But she said, reading your book, she said, there's a lot of passion, a lot of drama, a lot of disappointments, and redemption. And she thought that I should write it. So she kind of coursed me into writing the script. It's a very inspirational movie, you know, about, you know, a young kid who went through some turmoil and teenager and as adult. You know, we're not perfect, and that's what the story is about. And there is redemption. There is light at the end of that tunnel. It's a story that needs to be told, and I've been hearing this from everyone, you know, and that's what we're working on.
Avila and Have I Done All I Can Do? For more information on Bobby Avila's book, Fathers, The Journey to the Grammys, go to meettheavilas.com. My Awesome Empire continues in just a moment.